three of your texts summoning me immediately, if not sooner.
I need your help.
You've come to your senses. You're gonna grovel and beg for your job back.
No, no, I've worked for it for 3 years, so I'm done there. But the only person I will break my back for is my dad. So, I want to reinvent the Haunted Star and turn it into a successful business.
I never got the impression that Luke cared about profits. Don't you think you should run it by him before you start reinventing?
He's gone.
Yeah, he's in rehab, right?
He left 15 minutes after checking in.
That's not too surprising.
Right, so I was gonna get Spinelli to track him down, but then I realized that we'd be dragging him back to the same situation that made him leave in the first place.
You guys were just trying to help.
But he didn't want help, and it wasn't helping by constantly hounding him about being an alcoholic.
Okay, well, what alcoholic wants that?
But he's different, and I should have trusted my initial instincts. I mean, him in a 12-step program. What planet are we on?
The planet of good intentions.
Okay, so I think I can give him something to come back to if I fix up this place.
You mean like redecorating? Because this decor is so stuck in
me. Yeah, I think I want to maybe redecorate. I want to get a younger clientele, and I would love it if you would help me. Lulu,
thanks,
you would be so good at this. You're so good at knowing what's hot, what's going to be hot. You do it for Crimson. You could do it for here.
Lulu, I'm sorry. Together again. You can redecorate this casino from top to bottom, but it's not going to bring your dad back.
Hey, you had anything with her?
What's going on?
An anonymous call, that's in trouble.
Go in there.
All right, what the hell's going on?
Go in there. Go in there.
Oh. You got a corpse in your chair. I definitely want to hear this.
I never see this.
Don't touch anything.
No, I'm guessing she's the one who killed Brandon, right?
Well, yeah, she escaped from police custody last night. My question is, how did she wind up dead
in
your office?
You're going to have to ask Anthony Zaccaro, because I'm sure he hired her to frame Abby for Brandon's murder, and then he let her get arrested and arranged for her to escape, and then he killed her before she could talk.
Ties it up pretty nicely.
That's where Anthony's headed, isn't it?
Well, unless we get evidence against him, you're going to be a suspect too, you know?
You believe that? Come on.
No.
Now, what do you mean? Why me?
maybe as a warning, a statement to anyone who messed with Michael or anyone
else. Okay, hold on here, okay? If I had whacked her, she would have never been found. And I wouldn't have whacked her and put her in my office so Brenda and her son could walk in here.
Maybe that's the whole point. Make yourself look like the victim when, in fact, you pulled the trigger.
Because I'm always looking for sympathy? Is that what you're saying?
No, I'm just letting you know how I'd investigate it, that's all.
The best thing for you to do right now, Dante, is to forget you were even here.
Okay.
I know that it can really hurt when your parents leave. There's this sense of emptiness that you can fill with denial, self-destructive behavior, accomplishment, all of which I have tried. But in the end, it's just better to accept it.
Well, I'm sorry about Frisco and Felicia, but my dad is nothing like them.
Yet Luke up and leaves again and again.
Not because he doesn't care.
Lulu, I get that, but a terrible thing has happened. He killed Jake, and Luke doesn't want to quit drinking, so he left.
And I have to give him a reason to come back, and he is at his best when he has a sense of purpose.
Purpose, as in running a bar and casino?
Yes, he loves it when this place is noisy and crowded and filled with people, sheep to fleece, as he puts it.
That was before the accident.
And his drinking got out of control after the accident. He's hurting by the way my family's treated him. I shouldn't have gone along with the tough love situation, so I need to make it up to him.
Okay. Devil's advocate here. What if Luke never comes home to see his new and improved Haunted Star?
He's gonna come home. And when he does, I'm gonna show him that I love him and I accept him the way that he is.
The female victim, she's shot in the chest. The body's cold, so send someone over here ASAP.
You're giving somebody a lot of work.
Well, I'd rather do this the right way instead of you trying to cover it up and hanging a guilty sign around your neck.
Well, you already said I'm a suspect, right?
Well, yeah, don't worry, Sonny. You're gonna be exonerated. Just let the police do their job.
You'll be pulled off conflict of interest.
That's so be it. You know, I mean, probably someone who isn't partial should handle this.
Justice is served, is that right?
Sonny, what are you complaining about? You've never done any time anyway.
Well, that's not nice. Who do you think called in the tip?
It was anonymous.
Anthony had to have arranged it.
Well, if he did, I'll find out.
And you know he covered his tracks. It's going to be very difficult to prove he killed anybody.
Well, you know, prisons are full of criminals who think that exact same thing.
All right, I'm gonna call Diane. I'm gonna make arrangements. If you need me to come down to make a statement, whatever you need, I'm there.
What do you think this is all about?
You want me to incriminate myself?
No, I think it's a lot for Anthony to go moving a body around. Pretty risky for him to do that just to pull a prank on you to make your life more difficult.
I think he's got an ulterior motive. Something bigger that Anthony is after.
Like what?
I know Luke is gone, and I know you know, because the doctor I spoke to said you'd already been there.
Yeah, I'm sorry I didn't call, but I figured you'd go searching for my dad.
And you don't want to find your father?
No, my first instinct was to drag him back here, but then I realized that we need to give him a reason to come home.
We're fresh out of reasons. He chose alcohol over friends and family.
Well, I think you're being too hard on him.
And I think you're behaving like a classic codependent.
Tracy, I love you. I know you have good intentions, but you are pissing me off right now, and so is Lucky.
I understand.
You were both insanely relentless about getting Dad to go to rehab for an issue that we made worse. So on top of feeling guilty about Jake, he also feels like he's failed everyone.
I did what I thought was best.
Well, that's what I'm doing now.
Rearranging the chairs in a closed casino?
No, I am going to revamp the Haunted Star. I've been working all morning on ways to give it a new look, to get a new clientele, and to have it turn a profit.
Sorry, that plan is not workable on any level.
How can you say my plan isn't workable?
Do you honestly think if you fix up the Haunted Star, your father's gonna happily come trotting home?
This place is a symbol for him.
Yes, it's a symbol of high-stakes poker games and drunken binges.
When he was at his most destructive moment, how did he express it? He trashed this place and almost torched it.
And you stopped him. Maybe you shouldn't have.
Are you saying you want this place to go up in flames?
It's insured. Really, it's probably insured for more than it's worth.
I cannot believe that you would joke about something like this.
Lulu, if there's any hope at all for your father, he has to hit bottom first, and he has to do it alone.
Well, that's your opinion, and I don't happen to share it.
Redoing the Haunted Star is just another form of enabling, and I'm not going to do it. I'm putting it up for sale.
No, this is a crime scene here.
I don't care. My dad is your boss, and I have something more important to discuss with you than the latest mob hit.
Okay, that's great. Well, you know what? I'm working right now, so maybe next time you can call or text or email,
okay,
whatever.
Okay, well, this is about Lulu. I'm worried about her. She's convinced that making the Haunted Star into a success will bring Luke back.
Yeah, we talked last night, and she wanted to go find him. I warned her that he didn't want to be found, and then she called Spinelli and got him to do a cyber track to find him or something.
Okay, well, now she's over at the Haunted Star right now, bouncing off the walls with this ridiculous idea that turning that place around will fix things, and it won't.
Well, she wants to be close to her father. I mean, she thinks this is going to be a new beginning for them.
When the reality is that her dad deserted her. You need to talk to her before she ends up in some sort of trouble.